Hello and welcome to today's topic, decompression sickness. Decompression sickness is a specialized form of gas embolism referred in the names Caisson's disease, Tiver's palsy, air embolism, aeroembolism, gas embolism, Benz, etc. What is gas embolism? Air, nitrogen and other gases can produce bubbles within the circulation and obstruct the blood vessels, causing damage to the tissue. It's referred as the gas embolism. In whom does this decompression sickness occur? It occurs in deep sea divers, workers in caissons, workers in offshore drilling and workers in tunnels. What are caissons? Any construction underwater is referred as caissons. Pathogenesis of decompression sickness. It is produced when the individual decompresses suddenly, either from a high atmospheric pressure to a normal level or from a normal level to a low atmospheric pressure. In divers, workers in caissons, offshore drillers and tunnel workers who descend to high atmospheric pressure, increased amounts of atmospheric gases like nitrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide are dissolved in the blood and tissue fluids. When such an individual ascends too rapidly, that is one who comes to normal level suddenly from a high atmospheric pressure, the gases come out of the solution as minute bubbles, particularly in the fatty tissues which have high affinity for nitrogen. These bubbles may coalesce together to form large emboli. In aeroembolism, seen in those who ascend to high altitudes or air flight in unpressured cabins, the individuals are exposed to sudden decompression from low atmospheric pressure to normal levels. This decompression sickness results in similar effects as in divers and in workers in caissons. The effects of decompression sickness may depend upon the depth or altitude reached by the diver or worker, duration of exposure to the altered pressure, the rate of ascent or rate of descent, the general condition of the individual. Pathological changes are more pronounced in sudden decompression from high pressure to normal levels than in those who decompress from the low pressure to the normal levels. The changes are more serious in obese persons as nitrogen gas is more soluble in fat than in body fluids. The clinical effects of decompression sickness are of two types. One is acute and the other is chronic. Acute form of decompression sickness. It occurs due to acute obstruction of small blood vessels in relationship of the joints and skeletal muscles. The features, bends, chokes and cerebral effects are the features of acute form. What are bends? Bends as the patient doubles up in bed due to acute pain in joints, ligaments and tendons. Chokes. Chokes occur due to accumulation of bubbles in the lungs resulting in acute respiratory distress. Cerebral effects manifest in the form of vertigo, coma and sometimes death. You can see some of the pictures mentioned above, representing the chokes, cerebral effects and the bends. Chronic form of decompression sickness. This is due to the foci of ischemic necrosis throughout the body, especially in the skeletal system. Ischemic necrosis may be due to embolism itself, but other factors such as platelet activation, intravascular coagulation and hypoxia might also contribute. Features: avascular necrosis of the bones occurring in the head of femur, tibia and humerus. Neurological symptoms may occur due to the ischemic necrosis in the CNS, which may include paresthesia and paraplegia. Lung involvement in the form of hemorrhage, edema, emphysema may be seen. This results in non-productive cough, dysphonia, and chest pain. Skin manifestations include itchy, patchy erythema, cyanosis, and edema. Other organs like parenchymal cells of the liver and pancreas may show lipid vacuoles. To conclude, safety isn't expensive, it's priceless. Thank you.